I would say, without wasting too much time, if our players are ready, let's find out who will advance to the top four. Here they are, and again, yesterday Adele had to actually beat the mirror match and prove that his Melfi version is better. Now the matchup is quite different, but compared to the last, they both know what their opponent are playing, and they had a chance to prepare for this matchup. So this always makes things interesting. And it can change, especially in the deck from Adele, the opening from his deck.
And I'm really curious to see how Giacomo will approach this match because over the last few months we have seen how popular Trap Brigade was, and we talked a lot how you can actually mix it with different engine, as we saw with Ancient Warriors, with Zodiacs, or like playing the pure version with Rescue Cat. But I think Adele actually gave us one of a kind deck that everyone cannot wait for to play after the October 1st Forbidden and Limited list, especially because like he's not actually playing tanky. So I really also like the fact that he's not playing Desire because of Obedience Cooled, which means that he doesn't want to banish his key cards, but he's playing Pot of Prosperity. So he really studied his deck, and we really liked yesterday the fact that certain cards like Cantalosa are very, very difficult to play around in a certain situation.
Okay, so we see a star already from Adele. It's not any Melfi card, but it's just the Fractal. And if we look at Giacomo's deck, he's actually maining Nibiru and Phantasmae. So that's it, yeah. He has a few spells which can be useful, like the Droplet and the Talent, but in terms of entrap, the only real entrap is the Nibiru. So we'll see how Adele is able to play around that.
Once again, Giacomo, I like how he decided to build this deck. Most of the players this weekend, I think it was split like 50-50. Some of them were playing a very small package of entraps, plus cards such as Triple Tactics Talent, Forbidden Droplet.
Yeah. Okay, so we see the Rescue Cat, and we know there is not a response in the deck from Giacomo. Great news here from Adele. We know how powerful that card can be when it resolves. And you can see here with the Obedience Cooled highlighted how many starter cards there are in Adele deck. And here we see already some of the detached cards. So the Cantalosa and the Melty Puppy. So already a great start and showcase of the uniqueness of this deck. But now we are always keeping in mind that the Nibiru can be there. At the moment he went for three summons. So we'll see if we get to see the joyous Melfi. No,
No.
instead it's probably gonna be just a Link Summon for the bow. Yeah. And it is the Phantasmae. Okay, so as mentioned, only Phantasmae and Nibiru in the deck from Giacomo. Definitely great to see the Phantasmae. And he will now try and look for the Nibiru.
Yeah, Phantasma has always been very annoying, especially because, like, in this kind of decks, it gives you advantage. But on the other hand, I think dealing with a 2400 attack monster is not always super easy.
No, and especially in this deck with the Cantalosa, it has additional utility. So I think it's a really good decision here. And we know there cannot be a response, but as soon as this Tri-Brigade hits the field, Giacomo can Nibiru. So we have to keep that in mind.
Maybe Adele yesterday had the chance to watch the stream and seeing that Giacomo is playing Nibiru, something that is not super popular, but
Yeah.
most of our players this weekend decided to main deck Nibiru, and everybody actually it paid off a lot.
Okay. So it's gonna resolve probably for the Bear Bow. And yeah, then the only doubt that we mentioned is that Adele is only playing one copy of Revolt, which really is the only thing that I'm not the biggest fan of. Ooh, but this is a lot
Wow.
of commitment. And if Nibiru comes down here, that's definitely scary. So Let's see. Giacomo definitely thinking about this. Do you think he's gonna bring out the oaf or?
Yeah. Okay, makes sense. I think this is like next step for Agel.
Yeah, we see the Appaloosa, but the difference between this matchup is that we see the Joyous Melfi here, and this was one of the cards that absolutely won him the mirror match. And here we can see the Appaloosa for two, obviously weaker when facing Fantasme, but luckily for Adele there wasn't any Biru, because with the way he ordered these plays, I think he would have been punished really, really heavily. So he now gets to draw a card and then search for the one copy of Revolt.
Yeah, I mean, if Nibiru was there, I think he would have been actually destroyed by it. And now he gets the only copy of Revolt, who is actually paying off for him, and I think this is even better of what we have seen so far over the next few months.
For sure, the best opening we have ever seen from a Tri-Brigade deck.
Yeah.
Usually, as we mentioned, the Appaloosa, Oath, and Revolt is the best opening, but here Adele went even a step further with the Joyous Melfi, which we'll try to bring up for you guys on screen soon. But it's essentially one or two more negates, because it destroys a card thanks to the Cantalosa.
And now back to Giacomo. Dealing with this situation, of course, is not easy. He has the Fantasmi, which can slightly cause Adele, you know, some thoughts, but I mean,
yeah, it's especially annoying because Appaloosa is 1600, so if he wants, he can try and push and negate it. But of course, Dragon Link usually is not able to deal with this board. We know that Droplet is in the deck, so I think Giacomo, alongside the triple tactic talent, Droplet is the card that can change this game upside down.
Yeah, it's not easy for him. We have to see what he has in. Okay, he starts with the Rocket Synchron.
Okay.
Now, I think it's not easy, because he has to think very hard about it, because if he goes for the Striker Dragon, then there's the Joyous Melfi as well.
Yeah. As we can see here, he goes for the Joyous Melfi. We saw it yesterday. It's really, really, really strong, because it essentially means you can destroy two cards, one right away with the Cantalosa and one with the Melfi Puppy.
Yeah.
So this is absolutely great, great, great stuff. So for anyone who missed it yesterday, this is the main combo he goes for. So
I think I'm very convinced that this deck will be in the upcoming future one of the most played with this version, because like it impressed us a lot, but especially with all the resources he can put up with like a couple of cards.
The only thing is that, as I mentioned, it does target. So there was some room for consideration for the Phantasmite to negate the Cantalosa. Not sure if Giacomo considered it, but of course the Appaloosa was there. So, and now the Melfi Puppy is also really annoying, because it's another Cantalosa from the deck. So you can see here, very, very unique deck, but essentially put up two negates with the Appaloosa, one with the, and then three bounce and destroys with the Melfi plus the Revolt. So it's essentially six negates, which is as many as you can wish for. Again, outside of Droplet, this is gonna be a miracle from Giacomo.
Yeah, I mean, I cannot think of any other card except for Droplet. Like,
yeah, Droplet and Talent are ways to start things off. Otherwise, this is really an upfield battle, and here you can see on screen the Melfi Puppy highlighted again. It essentially represents a Cantalosa summon from the deck, therefore another destruction. So,
Giacomo, I think, is thinking deeply about this decision. It's not easy. Like, he has to deal with I don't know how many problems. Like,
yeah, it's essentially a chess game at this point. He knows what his opponent has, but that's so much that every single move matters. And the talent is definitely a great, great way to start things off. it's not even obvious which effect he activates, and in the end he draws two, so maybe he thinks that the only way to win this game is to top deck the droplet, and he's trying to go for that out.
Yeah, I mean, he might have been... he could have considered to actually pick another effect, but...
Yeah, it's not even easy, because if you take control, then there is still the Revolt, the Puppy, and now the Chaos Space comes down. It doesn't matter too much at the moment. Definitely great, especially with the Router to discard. So, the end was really strong by Giacomo, but I'm not sure if it's enough to break this opening from Adele.
With a hand like this, I think he could have dealt with Apollosa and the Oath and the Revolt. But with the Joyous Melfi...
Yeah. The Melfis are doing what they need. And now we see the first activation of Apollosa to negate the Router. Why not? As given the chance, he immediately uses them. He knows that Apollosa is only 800 now. Yeah. So very weak to any attack.
Very difficult from Giacomo here. Can't feel him, like.
Okay. Yeah, as expected, for now, he will try to just go for the Weather Buster. Here, he could enter Battle Phase, maybe, to just try and force out the Apollosa, but we see the off.
Yeah, I think it makes sense to activate the off here, right?
Sure.
He goes with the Phantasmi. Yeah, that is why we were saying that this is annoying, because like, if Phantasmi was not here, I think that we were not seeing all this action.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and he gets sent back. Again, not using the Phantasmi.
Yeah.
Interesting decision, because now, sure, there is another Melfi Puppy activation, but... he's really not taking the negate into consideration. Because it's not like Apollosa destroys, so if you force it out, you can still then play without thinking about Apollosa. And we might see the battle phase here. Yeah. And... interesting, okay. Yeah, he attacks the Oath. And if we just move to the end phase, this revolt is going to crush Giacomo completely.
Yeah, I don't think that's that much that Giacomo can do. Okay, he has the
Red Eyes. So nice. Red Eyes coming down, but now we can see the Melfi Puppy being activated to just destroy it right away. And this is what happened. So great stuff by Giacomo. Melfi Puppy. Back to the end, Cantalosa is summoned from deck to destroy the Red Eyes. What a interesting deck from Adele.
Yeah, how crazy is this?
Like, yeah.
No, because if the Joyous Melfi was not there, I think Giacomo could have dealt with the Borov. Like, of course it was not easy because of Lusa, the Ancient Oath, and the Revolt. But like this...
It's very tough. The Weather Buster is in the end, but it cannot really be used, and there are only two more cards. So, definitely tough, and I think we might see an end phase really soon here. Giacomo tried his best. We still see if the decision with the talent could have paid off. And yeah, I think he has seen enough, so Adele... put up the strongest opening from Tribigate we have probably ever seen ever since the deck was released, and it was all thanks to his Melfi build. So very well played. He didn't even open up the Obedience Schooled, but it was all thanks to the Rescue Cat, and absolutely astonishing play.
Yeah, he basically started things off with Rescue Cat and Fractal. So
yeah,
basically two cards this entire field. So
yeah, absolutely great stuff. And now Giacomo must figure out a solution. We can see that in his side decks he has Gamma and Artifact Lancia. Those are usually really good against the deck. But against this specific version, against, you know, both Obedient School and Rescue Cat, Lancia is okay, but you also lose a lot of advantage. But I still don't think he has much of a chance.
Exactly. So. I think you have to set them in nonetheless.
Rivalry, we saw how interesting it can be again yesterday with the Alter Guys matchup. But the Melfis could find a way to out it with the Cantalosa. So, again, maybe this deck really finding other ways to exploit the Tribe Brigade deck, which on his end can probably side in Nibiru.
Yeah.
And Lightning Storm, I guess. Going second, both are pretty solid. But he was already one of the players maining Lancia, which is not only good against Tribe Brigade, but almost as good against Dragon Link, so...
No, but I think Adele's deck is one of the most solid we have seen so far this weekend. Like...
15 entrops with Lancia, Ash, Veiler, Gamma and Impermanence, all in free offs in the main deck, so... He was already quite prepared to lose the die roll, and I gotta say, still, yesterday I didn't have the chance to spoil it, as Adele won 2-0, but if we get to see game 3, I will talk about Adele's side for going first, which I already mentioned I'm a big, big fan of, and we'll see. Maybe we'll just keep on chewing everyone and we'll never get the chance to see it in action.
No, it's not easy for Giacomo, because like his hand was, I think it was a very good hand. Like, he had the Phantasmic Cow Space, and once again, I think if you're not prepared for something like this, like Adele is putting up a show for since yesterday. Like, I think everyone at home is impressed with his deck, and I believe we will soon see a lot of players relying on the Melfi package.
Yeah, as you mentioned, the most impressive thing is that he's playing as if this was a tournament host after October 1st. No tanky, so no Zodiacs. So this is very impressive by him, and I can't wait to see if this deck will actually be picked up by a lot more people after this event and after the new Forbidden and Limited list. So.
Now, if you were Giacomo, how would you feel? Like, especially because we talked how many end traps Adele plays and the lineup play with only one card.
Yeah.
Not going to be easy for him.
No, it's never easy, and it's never pretty to be facing someone who, no matter what, could and will have an advantage because he's playing some cards that are not that known. So I really doubt that Giacomo prepared well against the Melfi package, and this is tough because you need to improvise and sometimes you don't have the necessary means to do it. So let's see. It seems like our players are ready, and no matter what, we have Vincenzo, who advanced to the top four with Dragon Link, who is watching this match and probably not feeling the best about Adele, since Giacomo is playing his same deck, so...
Yeah. I think you are more prepared for a Dragon League Mirror match rather than playing against a Tribe Brigade deck that actually can do basically everything.
But let's see, Giacomo now is going to go first. Gonna try once again to make the usual board of Hieratic Seal and Savage or something along those lines, but... We've seen multiple times how the deck can consistently do it. And he starts things off once again with the Seifert. Decent opening. But already here, if he gets to the Wyvern Buster, we could see a Lancia. Instead, he doesn't activate it. Interesting. He goes for the Striker, and Adele allows it.
That means he might have already...
Yeah, he could have the Dragons, he could have the Rocket Package ready, so... Let's see. There is no draw and lock in the deck for Adele, but there are plenty more entrops.
Lancia.
And yeah, wow. Okay. Yet again, we see a artifact Lancia coming down from Adele. As you mentioned, there is a big chance that if you don't see the cipher being activated, there is a Wyvern Buster or a Collapse Serpent already in the end. Giacomo will try his best. If he has a Tracer, this is decent.
Yeah.
And he does. So Tracer comes down. Even if he just wants to end the turn, he can make a Savage, you know, or a Seal. So that's what we are going to see at the moment. He makes the Seal. And yeah, sets one and pass. So not the greatest of openings, but with Artifact Lancia facing you, that's not super easy. And now Adele, again, in driver's lead, we'll see if he opens up the Obedience School this time. That's one of the key cards. But for now, we'll just activate the Fractal.
Okay, standard thing from him, like our last game.
We'll see if maybe Giacomo is holding the Rivalry from the side deck. That could hurt a lot. So the most obvious one would probably be the Tiding, which is what Adele will try and play around. And there it goes, so Obedience School activated by Adele. What a opening end once again. So great, great stuff. So, as we saw already and multiple times, this card alone is so good. And imagine if he didn't have the Fractal, this also could have given him the kit and the access. And now this is a big decision from Giacomo, already facing four monsters. And as you can see, the Nibiru would be really good, but outside of that, this deck, I don't think, has many downfalls.
No, I mean, I believe that Giacomo has the Tiding, because, like, if he has the River here, yeah, that would be good. Seems like Giacomo is thinking hard about this, because if he wants to activate the Seal and the Tiding, he really needs to be careful about that, because once again, Adele showing up very strong. Yeah, so many solutions here.
Even here, because the... We see the Lancia. Okay, so Lancia again coming down for both players. We had a match yesterday where we're seeing seven Lancias, and maybe this will be the trend for today as well, but I think Giacomo still gonna have to try and make some decisions. He's forced into the Seal. Do you think he brings back to the end the Cantalosa?
Yeah, it will make sense.
I think so,
it will make sense.
Because if you get the puppy, then they can special summon it during the end phase. And it seems like he's really thinking about it. Okay, instead he goes for the kit. Interesting. The Ash Blossom goes and stop the Steel.
This is huge.
Great, great stuff again by Adele, who now in Memphis 2 has a few options. He can go for the Melfi, once again, the Joyous Melfi. He can even go for a Link Summon first to go for a Tri-Brigade. For example, special summoning back the kit and then making the Joyous Melfi. That can work. Still a lot of options, and there are not many cards left for Giacomo.
What does he have? Like, because he's still considering if activating his set card, but looks like...
As expected, we already see the Link Summon. He can special summon back whatever, honestly, Giacomo would have spin back, and it is the kit. So here, a lot of options. We can see the Joyous Melfi, and this was just the most obvious line. It represents two disruptions. So... very annoying for Giacomo.
And this is like a demonstration how Lancia is not hurting Adele's deck at all.
Yeah. And that is it. So Giacomo definitely hurting a lot. I think the Lancia was overall hurting both players, but in the end it is what's keeping this game 2 still on tracks. And now, if that's a tiding, it's gonna be interesting, but still, he needs to deal with a lot, because the Joyous Melfi, as we have already seen plenty of time, represents a lot of disruption.
Okay, now he brings back the Tracer from the graveyard, and of course here he needs something out of his deck, because that Tracer alone could not be enough.
Yeah, so
he's are thinking about this. Not going to be easy. I mean, if he activates the effect, then he has the Joyous Melfi.
So he's holding two cards at the same time. The tiding is helpful, but he really needs to be careful when he activates it.
He's considering it, because now what would you do? You can activate the Tracer, but then if you don't have an answer to the Joyous Melfi, then you're in trouble. So he goes for the Tracer as well, which is fine. If he has the tagging, then it would be very interesting.
Yeah, for now he's...
Yeah, he brings the Recharger on the field. Adele still not concerned about it. I think he's considering if activating the Joyous Melfi or not. He can also consider Giacomo having either a Collapse Center or the Wyvern Buster from the first turn of play. Here comes the Chaos Ruler.
So Chaos Ruler comes down and... let's see what he's going to reveal from the deck. As mentioned, Adele is playing a lot of Enchops, but for now it's... Ooh, and the Levianeer is one of the options, so that can change a lot of stuff. I think it's probably a no-brainer. I can't quite tell the second if it's the Call-Up, because that's also really, really good. But yeah, it is the Call-Up Serpent. So interesting reveal for sure. And as already mentioned multiple times, the card we will highlight soon on screen, it's the card which is pretty much doing everything for Adele, and it is the Calantosa.
Okay, he took the Collapse Serpent, so I think Giacomo has a plan. And now... Okay, he banished the Seafer to get the Levianeer as well, and now... This could be a game changer. Okay.
So, we finally see the Joyous Melfi activation. It will be sent back to the extra deck to bring back both the Puppy and the Calantosa. And let's see if he wants to respond with the Tiding.
Yeah, I think he has to consider if he has the Tiding, right?
Let's see through. So, as mentioned, we will see the Calantosa. But this is also kind of scary, because as we know, the Chaos Ruler can be summoned back and just force out the second activation. So I gotta say, Giacomo quickly starting to understand the mechanics of this deck might actually win this game without too much effort. So the kit resolves, giving just another Tri Brigade for next turn to Adele. And it is the Keras.
And now still Giacomo has the Collapse Serpent and the Levianeer, last card, we don't know it. Still,
those are still enough to pretty much destroy him, so... He has the Chaos Ruler, he has literally a lot of stuff going on. He just has to decide whether he feels like he can go all in, risk an Ibiru and just OTK, or... set up a field for next turn, and it seems like he will go for the Levianeer now. Okay, so it seems like he will try to use it to destroy the entire field from Adele. Yeah, so the Puppy is chained, he will He sent back to the end. Carantosa is summoned. Oh, no, it's actually not. So maybe okay. He might have another in his hand. So this hurts quite a bit. Unfortunately, the second Carantosa might be in the end from Nadal. So he gets to summon the kit from the deck. And now the Levianier can make quick work of his field. And he does. So both monsters are destroyed. And for the first time this weekend, it looks like Adele will be losing a game, but let's not call it over yet. Giacomo still has a lot of decisions to make, and not easy ones, for sure.
I will be more than happy if I were Giacomo, especially because like the Carantosa, of course, would have been better than the kit. Maybe as the third cob in hand. So now I think he has a chance. Because with the Collapse Serpent, and then you can take advantage out of it.
Yeah, even the Chaos Ruler, yeah. You know, bringing it back, it's a lot of damage. So this won't be easy. And he needs to make a play soon. As there are 23 minutes remaining, so we're pretty much half the way through this round. Really having a lot of back and forth matches this weekend outside of Adele. In round one yesterday, I think we have seen a lot of players who could have really gone either way. Yeah. So, okay. Ooh, and we have the red eyes.
Nice.
I mean, this is much, much better. Again, drawing it without playing the metal. So, yeah, this is huge. Drawing the red eyes twice in a row. Really, really allowing you to push a lot of damage with the PTST, you can get it back too. But for now, let's see.
This hurts a lot.
Yeah, he's just gonna try and go for game here. Makes sense. I don't think your opponent showed any signs, but honestly, yesterday and even this morning in the previous round, we witnessed an incredible Nibiru. Out of nowhere, maybe we will see it again, and that would be a great way to start day two today. Let's see.
And I think Giacomo here actually.
Last line of defense. Adele picks up a card, puts one in the bottom, and you really need to pick up a Nibiru. Otherwise, I think his hopes are over for this game.
If he doesn't pick up a Nibiru, he's in trouble.
Yeah.
And Giacomo still has the Collapse Serpent.
He has a lot of resources, as you mentioned. He can go for the Collapse, even to the Beastie, bring back the Red Eyes. He has so, so many options. But the only card he really needs to pay attention to is Nibiru.
Yeah.
I don't think there is anything else as... often it happens, I gotta say.
Because now we can even consider to OTK if he really wants
to. Yeah, for sure. That's the main goal. His opponent field is empty, now he goes for the Collapse Serpent. Or not? No. Yeah, okay. And I don't think we can wait much longer if we are Adele. He has a few options in the extra deck for sure, but he now goes again for the OTK line with the Chaos Ruler engraved. He now gets the Wyvern Buster and he doesn't even do too much. He can summon those, bring back the Chaos Ruler, and is more than enough.
Yeah.
So with a triple burst dragon on the field to OTK, but let's see how he wants to play it. Now it comes the Savage, and here it's Nibiru now or never.
Yeah.
I don't think there is any more time. Let's see if Adele has the Nibiru. Otherwise, the Savage could negate it later on, and he might have it because he's thinking about it. So we might see it. Instead, it's the Impermanence. Okay. Yeah. This is interesting because it could scare off Giacomo. If you see this Impermanence here, you might think, okay, so he's low rolling the Nibiru still. At the same time, it's not even that obvious because if he really had both Nibiru and Impermanence, you can just wait. so it doesn't make much sense to use it right here and right now. So I don't know, a little bit of a mind game. If you're Giacomo and even you just bring back the Chaos Ruler, I think this is game. So let's see how brave he is, but I don't think he has much of a choice. You just bring back the Chaos Ruler and pretty much swing for game.
You know, a Cantalosa in Adel's hand.
So he makes the access code. And
Okay,
I think he has seen enough. Okay, so a little bit of a mind game, but as mentioned, Giacomo really, really played this game well. He was never in a position where he could have lost, but I gotta say, once again, the Artifact Lancia showing off absolutely incredible all weekend long, even in a non-Tribe Brigade matchup. So now we go to game 3, and we gotta understand what they're gonna bring out. And finally, for the first time, I can tell you guys about Adel side deck for going first. If you know me, you know that I have a few cards that I'm a big fan of, and in particular, one of them is Artifact Sanctum. And he has 3 copies in the side deck, of course, with the 1 copy of Artifact Sight, but let's not forget, Artifact Lancia is also an option. Not only is it an entrap, but you can summon it with the Sanctum. So essentially, he's playing 6 copies of the card, but in some matchup, the Sight is even better, and I am totally in love with this choice. Sure, the droplet can interact with the Sight, but there are very few things that can go wrong if they don't ash the Sanctum. And when you play a deck like Tribe Brigade, usually the ash should have came down during your own turn. So I really love the Sanctum, and I hope we will see more of it today. So it's gonna be interesting.
Well, Giacomo, still, on the other hand, can side in the Gamma and the Lancia. As previously, we saw that the Lancia didn't really hurt Adel's much, but still, against the Tribe Brigade deck, we saw how powerful this card is. It's really up to Adel, because, like, I think between the two of these two guys, if he starts things well, I think he's in a very good position. It was not easy for Giacomo to come back into game one, as we saw. If you really can put up a field like the same one we saw in game one, it's not going to be easy for Giacomo. Of course, the Sanctum gives him another opportunity to bring up the Lance if he really wants to, or the Sight, which is...
This is one of the few matchups in which the decision can be difficult. Usually the Sight is a no-brainer, but Dragon Link, although the Sight is of course really good, there are a few spots in which Lancia is even better. So, no matter what, I think we'll have a very interesting game 3. And as we already mentioned, one of these guys is going against Vincenzo in the top 4. So... either a mirror match, so the Dragon Link, and just as a reminder, out of this top 8 duelists who qualified for the day 2, 7 different decks, and Dragon Link is the only deck, as you obviously saw, both in round 1 and in round 2, being represented by 2 different players. All of the other decks are unique, and this means in top 4, if we get to see a Dragon Link mirror match, well, I think that's a big statement of how good of a meta goal that deck was for this weekend. So, interesting stuff, but now it seems like they're picking up their decks, and let's find out who will win and meet Vincenzo in the top 4. Okay. Once again, Adel really trying to pick up Obedience or Rescue Cat, by far the 2 best cards in his deck. And he starts things off instead with Prosperity. So, again, really good. Still more likely looking for one of those opening cards. And we'll see if he decides to banish 3 or even 6. We saw him banishing 6 more often, but... he is not that obvious in this deck, since the extra deck space is quite limited, but he does go for 6. So, bold choice, and I guess with the 1 revolt, it's also less important. But let's take a look. Okay, we see the Rescue Cat, pretty good option, and we see the Obedience. Okay, wow. Whew. This is a great reveal. I think the obedience is just too strong of a card to miss out on.
I mean, one better than another. I think the decision is on obedience or rescue cat.
Yeah, but I think obedience is just a better rescue cat because it summons three instead of two. It does lock you under beasts, but it's just incredible. But instead, he picks up Nenibiru. Interesting from Adele. He probably already has a very good combo end, and he was looking for stuff like, you know, Call by the Grave, and definitely not something you see every day. Wow.
I think he wants to put pressure on Giacomo, because like, here comes the Fractal, and as we saw earlier, he was always able to put up not only the Tri-Brigade combo, but as well the Joyous Melfi. And let's see if he has the Rescue Cat. Oh, okay, he has the key.
He doesn't. So for now, he's having more of a slower start. And I'm very surprised by this decision to miss out on the Obedience still. No Lancia coming down from Giacomo. But we will see a Gamma. Okay. And this is huge. If we don't see any other card, we only see the Ash, which I'm not the biggest fan of. It only denies the inevitable. But we see the Burbau, and now we can see the Gamma. Oh wow, so strong start.
A Phantasme.
Are you a fan of this?
No,
because honestly, I mean, you see the Burbau. Yeah.
I mean, I would have waited if I were Giacomo, right? You could have waited, just keep the Gamma, then activate the Phantasme.
Exactly. So I don't know, a little bit of a decision here by Giacomo foregoing the Gamma completely, which is essentially making so that Adele's decision to ash the Gamma was pretty good, because usually ashing the Gamma is not the greatest because it allows them to activate it later on in the turn. But okay, this Phantasmai apparently was good enough for Giacomo to forego the Gamma completely, and now we'll just see the one copy of Revolt getting added to the end.
I mean, of course the Phantasmai is good, but he could have waited, for example, this point, maybe, like, you know.
And now, yeah, Adele plays it well, chains in a way where the activation cannot be negated, so he's guaranteed to get the revolt. But this opening seems rather underwhelming, if I'm being honest, compared to what we have seen in the past, so.
I'm curious to see why he got the Nibiru.
Yeah. It seems like he will just end here and now, forgoing both the Rescue Cat and especially the Obedience Schooled for this line. Let's see if it will pay off, and it's also saddens me to see only one back row, because that means there is no Artifact Sanctum by Adele. So Giacomo in a great spot with the plus one from the Phantasme, so let's see how he will approach this turn. And it's a great way to do it with the cow space.
Of course, like, if I were Giacomo, I would be happy.
Ah, another rush from Adele.
Good.
Oh. Pretty good again. Okay. And now Giacomo gonna go and activate a quick launch. So both really showing up strong. This can give him the Tracer or... pretty much a no-brainer. If he wants to go for the Striker Dragon, he can. But yeah, there is not much Adele can respond to. He has to decide when he wants to activate this revolt.
Yeah, I think now you just wait. And of course, Giacomo can play around Nibiru, because like, he knows that Adele is keeping it.
Yeah. He has to be careful and play around Nibiru as well as he can. At the moment, he only summons two monsters, so... That's why I also don't like too much adding Nibiru in general. When you give your opponent the knowledge and when they're caught off guard, is a huge difference.
No, I mean, I can understand if you don't have the Rescue Cat because you can be, you know, Ashed or Gamma, but I mean, the Obedience Cool there, I think it might have been Adele a very huge advantage. Maybe it just felt safer, you know, adding the Nibiru, just in case.
And now, gets back the tracer and activate the fuse spell. So we are at the point where we could see, you know, the fifth summon being the savage, but for now, to keep just you guys reminder, if you just joined, Adele is holding an Ibiru in his hand, which we know of because of Pot of Prosperity, and Giacomo is trying his best to play around it at the moment on his fourth summon when this hits the field. So from now on, he needs to play around Nibiru because he doesn't have any more space for mistakes. And that's what I was saying. If he goes for the Savage here, he's pretty much forcing his opponent to do something, but he will instead go for the ruler. And let's see what he can pick up. For now, not much of a choice. Okay. Decent options. And now Nibiru is alive from Adele. So makes sense that he went for the Chaos Ruler. At least he's guaranteed the plus one and the ruler in grave. So if you are Adele, when do you think you want to activate this Nibiru?
I think here you just want to wait for Giacomo to use and waste as many resources as he can. And here, I mean, he has the revolt, so still he can wait. But the Nibiru, I mean, if I were Giacomo, I would not, like, waste so many resources because he knows it, you know? And now if he activates the Wyvern Buster, then the more he plays, the more cards he uses.
Just asking for account. As we know, the revolt is there, and there is only the Nibiru in the end, I think, from Adele.
Yeah.
So Giacomo, this time, on the opposite as last game, he has full knowledge of the cards from his opponent, and he just has to play around Nibiru and revolt. So not the easiest, but for a deck like Dragon Link, it's doable. And something important to keep in mind is that we have 7 minutes remaining, which is not a ton of time, and it might mean that we see a game stolen maybe in time, which could go either way,
yeah.
Really.
I think
the now we see the revolt.
Yeah, in the battle phase and didn't activate the Nibiru then. In the... Okay.
Yeah, because now this looks like it could be much more Giacomo's game than Adele's.
Yeah.
But with 6 minutes and 50 seconds remaining, we could really see a steal.
Wow.
Ooh, but this is huge. Okay. This Forbidden Droplet is absolutely huge.
Giacomo, I think we have to give credit to him because he played very well, although knowing Adele having the Nibiru. So he just go for the Chaos Ruler, having the plus one, and the droplet here is huge.
Yeah, this droplet makes a ton of difference, especially for the life points, as I was saying. But at the same time, Giacomo is not in the best of situations now. Because he is ahead, but 6 minutes are still enough where Adele can come back and deal some damage next turn.
Yeah.
So this is going to be a very interesting game. And now the Omen, as Adele played it well, will even trigger and give him an extra card. So
yeah, Adele needs to be careful about the time here, because
yeah, and as you can see here, now Giacomo is playing as fast as he can, but he needs to play around Nibiru. So yeah. This is not easy. We probably see a Hieratic Seal and that's it. So I think as soon as possible, he will now get the plus one back. But you can see he's getting scared. He's getting scared about this because 5 minutes, not much time. Let's see. So if he goes for the Seal and Adele wants to use the Nibiru, then that's a little weird because the seal triggers and then you can get another seal.
Yeah.
And I think Giacomo is a decent spot, especially because he can combo off.
Yeah.
You get the Collapse Serpent, you get a summon back, you get the Chaos Ruler back, so that's not the greatest. So I think Giacomo is playing really well, but needs to be careful about this 5 minutes remaining. And yeah, we do see the Nibiru.
That makes sense.
Yeah, definitely better here than on the seal. But still allows Giacomo to combo off now. Slightly, but he has the option. So he can get the collapse and the ruler back. So at least have the seal. And at the moment, there is another problem, which is Adele. Not sure why, but he decided to get both the nerve and the kit. Which means that if he instead went for a Keras, he had a much better option. But
he passed
back to Adele. Wow. So now it's Adele who is in the driver's seat. And if there is no entrap coming down from Giacomo... Ooh, the Lancia! This is huge. Wow. Lancia again, topping these players in their tracks, and I think he really has to play it fast because the token was definitely prosperity. Yeah. So sets one pass, really need to play fast now, and I'm worried that Giacomo will just have too much going on here.
Wow.
He even at the Noctovision, and we didn't see a Sanctum once again from Adele.
And this was very unfortunate. I think Lancia was the very key card of every single side deck this weekend. Like, once again showing up and stopping Adele's turn.
Yeah, I think many of these duelists will advance it to the top 8 and are doing well, are even maining Lancia, and we can really see why. So if you guys have been watching, definitely pick the card up and start using it, because it is really showing up strong this weekend.
Not that much Adele can do at the moment. We don't know. We know that he has the kit in hand. We don't know this last set, but...
Yeah, it seems more and more like we might get to see a all Italian top 4 and an all Dragon Link top 4, which is just almost unpredictable if we look at the pairings at the beginning of the event yesterday. But sometimes this is how it goes, and unfortunately, as I mentioned, only 2 minutes remaining. So even if we would have a different game, which I don't think that's the case, because it looks like Giacomo is really playing well here. Time is an issue, and the nerve is gonna take a beating here. Yeah,
especially because like the token is
big. Token is huge. I think it was 4700 or something along those lines. So this is actually enough to win the game if there is nothing from Adele. Let's see. Damage is being calculated. We see an attack. It could be almost exactly what he needs. Probably slightly short, because he had the 3000 from the Nibiru, and now we get to see the Keras.
With 1 minute on the clock.
2000 left for Adele, but only 1 minute remaining, and Giacomo still has plenty more plays in Memphis 2. Even reveals his own copy of Nibiru, which he has been holding, and with the router, I think this was way too much for Giacomo to be dealing with.
Anyways, well played by Giacomo, like...
Yeah, no, absolutely. He's really showing why he's here. He had a very good match yesterday, and again today against an opponent which he was surely not as prepared. You can see he probably give a little chance of his opponent to fight back, but with 30 seconds remaining, there is no way. I don't think there is even an option for the deck to deal as much damage in one turn, and I think we might even see an handshake soon, because Giacomo is not stopping. So
yeah, Savage Dragon just in case. I mean,
and it's not like he even played it slow.
Yeah,
he played at a very very relevant pace, and plays back to Adele. Time is gonna be called very soon, and that means the winner will be Giacomo. Adele, unfortunately, breaks our heart, but we have to give a huge shout out to both of these guys. But before further ado, congratulations to Giacomo, and let's go back to us for the post-match discussion.